Okay, we're doing kinematics today, right? Okay, hey, let's go straight to the point, okay? Do some rubbish first, okay? The rubbish are the, okay, what is the distance? What is displacement? Okay, what is speed? What's velocity? And come to here, too bad, everything only have accelerations. Okay? Now, you know what is distance, right? When object move from here to here, the distance is this whole length, right?
Mm.
What's displacement?
The straight line.
The straight line. More than that?
The shortest possible.
Yes, shortest possible straight line, you still have one more thing. We don't draw displacement this way, right?
We call direction.
Yes. Direction, how to draw? You use a, we use a arrow. Arrow, okay? So you need an arrow, because if you just one straight line, you don't know which is an arrow. You have an arrow. This arrow is very, very important. Arrow, okay? So, this displacement, okay? So, speed, at any instant is how fast, how slow it is, right? Okay, so can speed be less than zero? No, right? Okay, so the slower speed is zero, okay? So, velocity, okay? Velocity is a speed in a specific direction, okay? Acceleration is the change in speed in a specific direction, okay? Change in velocity in a specific direction, okay? So this is a vector, this is a scalar. Okay, so in the difference, we don't talk about the difference, okay? So we understand the magnitude of displacement, the magnitude of velocity, okay? Wow, the object bubble like that, okay? But let's talk about at this instant, okay? At here, okay? At this instance, so this is a displacement, right? And the direction of displacement is like that, right? Okay, so remember direction of displacement, most of the time, is not the direction of where you're heading at this instant. When you're heading at this instant, if you're this object, okay, it's this direction, right? You're facing this way. Okay, but the displacement is this way. Okay, so the direction of displacement, just draw. It will not be the direction of motions. Direction of where the motion is always the direction of velocity. Okay, so remember, direction of motions, where you're headed at that instant, is the same as the direction of velocity at that instant. Okay? Direction of accelerations in this whole process is downward. Right? It's g, right? And it's gravity, right? So therefore, direction of acceleration is always direction of... Okay? Direction of acceleration is always direction of resultant force. Okay? Resultant force, okay? Not any component force, but the resultant force. Because the resultant force means overall effect of the force. Only the overall effect of the force, of course, will give you overall effect of acceleration. Okay? And we can only see the overall acceleration. Can't see a component acceleration, that's very cheap. Okay? So, direction of acceleration, get from direction of force. Okay? So remember where to get the directions of these three things. Because I believe value-wise, you got no issue. Okay? So come to here. A max, we know. V equal to ds dt. Okay? V equal to ds dt. I think it's all in your notes, okay? A is equal to dv dt. Okay? So on the other hand, right? Change a little bit. You know that S is equal to integration of v dt. Okay? And then V is the integration of a dt. Okay? Sure, okay? So this is why you have displacement time graph and velocity time graph. Hey, be careful when they play around with the distance time graph and speed time graph. Okay, so when you have a graph, okay, case one, if it is use red color to indicate speed time graph, use black color to indicate displacement time graph. This is distance, okay, distance time graph like that, correct or not? Make sense or not?
Distance must be increasing.
Yeah, good, okay. This doesn't make sense. Distance can never drop, it keep accumulating only. Okay, so the most, if you're stopping, is level off. You can never come back. Don't measure more negative. You can't even come back, okay? If it's a speed time graph, right, what's the limitations for it, okay? The limitation of it is that, does it make sense? It makes sense, right? Okay, because speed can speed. Okay, red color is scalar. Okay, black color is vector. Okay, so if this case it makes sense. Okay, but when it comes to here, it doesn't make sense anymore because you cannot have negative speed. My slow speed is zero. Okay, and there's no direction inside a scalar. So there is some restriction. You do things with distance, and do things with speed. Distance, remember, can't even turn back. Okay, distance can only keep accumulating. Velocity can't even cannot go below zero. Okay, can't even go back. Of course, cannot go to zero also. Okay, cannot go below zero. Okay, good. Now, if you have vector, it's okay. Any way you want to draw. Okay, so if I have a vector in this way, the roller coaster like that. Okay, let's drop to this point. Okay. So the idea is that this is a displacement time graph. This is a vector. So what this is, let's say start with point A. Okay, point A. Okay, let's say it show until here is point B. Okay. So this is the mid of point B. So from point A to point B. Okay, and then come back here, and then come back here, and then go below point A. Point A, can you see it? Now, what I want to say is that most of the shape of the graph that you imagine in your world, okay, is normally the displacement time graph. Okay, so if you see an object in this shape throwing here and there, and you see a graph more or less looks like that, you have always visualized a displacement time graph. Okay, students get very confused because once come to velocity time graph, right, it's completely different from what they see because it's not talking about physical distance. You can't see it. It's not about fast, slow. Okay? So, a few things here. The gradient here is what?
Velocity,
right? Mm. Area on the graph?
This.
No meaning. So, how to know it's velocity? There's one trick, okay? This is meter per second. This is per second, right? So, this is meter only. Okay? Gradient is divide, right? So this is meter per second. Okay, so it's velocity. Multiply is meter times second. Meter times second doesn't make sense. Okay, meter times second, what is that? Don't have. Okay. So there's only one gradient. Okay, gradient is the velocity. If this is a distance, if this is a displacement, what is the distance corresponding? For the first portion, when you keep going. Now, the only difference between a distance and displacement is that the distance cannot go back. You got to keep going. Okay? So, the idea is that for this portion, you got to be the same. Because just keep going. No issue. The point is that when you turn back, you cannot turn back. Then what you do is to say that, now, this is the... So, what is the distance that you move is, you draw a horizontal line this way. You, from this point, right, this height, right, you drop the height, right? So the actual distance moved from this point is actually this distance. Can you see? Let's say this move from here to here, so it's down by so much.
Yeah.
This amount, right? Okay. So actually it means that from here to here, it moved the extra this amount. Okay? When it moved from this extra this amount, you gotta accumulate the amount of distance that it moved, right? So you draw the same arrow vectors up. Make sense? So therefore, this is what it is. Okay? So you keep drawing this way. Okay? So this is the distance time graph for this displacement time graph. You don't really care about all these things, okay? All you need to see is that when you turn down, you flip it up. When you turn down, you keep flipping up from that turning point. Got it? Okay.
The distance is the curvy line, everything together, the whole length.
You're right.
So it's not the shortest length, right? It's the curvy everything.
No. It's the shortest length. You mean this one?
The distance move.
The amount of distance that you move is the... So at this instance, okay, you are moving from A to B and try to go back to B, right? So it's as good as you move from B and you go a little bit further, keep going. Okay. Can you see the mirror world? And if you turn back, it still keep going. If you turn back, still keep going. Okay, so
I
that's the distance.
The distance
is the y-value. Yeah, it's the y-value.
Why isn't it the curve then?
Because it's time. You go along this, right? It's some distance, sometimes, right? The time doesn't make sense.
Oh,
if you talk about distance. Okay? So that means remember, stick to the y-value. Okay? Now what I want to say is that, so how do you, in a very fast way, okay, remember you only have 40 seconds for one MCQ or something like that? 40, right? Still?
Yeah.
I think roughly that, okay? So, if I have this, okay, how to come out the distance time graph? Okay, I think I better draw somewhere in between, okay, because I gotta keep flipping up. Okay, displacement time graph. All you do is that when it turns, you flip. So become like that. Okay. Then like that, it turns again, right? Okay, keep going up. So it's another. So kind of things like this is the same as this. Okay, but this is flipped in this way, about this line. Okay, so we got to learn how to draw this, okay? So this displacement and distance. Hey, same thing for speed and velocity. You just flip in this way. Makes sense. Okay. Let's try. Okay. Velocity time graph. Okay. For example, if you have things like that. Okay. Then at this instant, your speed is dropping. Oh no, no, it's different. Speed time graph, right? You gotta make the absolute value. Because speed can turn back. But it just cannot be go zero. Okay? So remember, for example, you have 2 meters per second here. Okay, let's say you have -1 meter per second here. Okay, at this instant, what is the speed? It is 1 meter per second. Okay, so when you have negatively increasing, actually just go positive increasing in the same amount. Okay, so speed, very simple, just make the absolute value of the velocity. Okay. But the distance and distance restriction is worse. You go flip every time you have the downward motion. Cool. 1 p.m. SMS I received now. What happened to the SMS? Is not okay. So good. Okay. Basic things. Okay. Velocity, time. If I have something like that, okay, at any instance, the gradient is acceleration, okay, because this is meter per second, this is per second, so this is meter per second square, okay, and area of the graph, okay, is meter per second times second, so it's meter, so this is actually a displacement, okay, but be careful about this, okay, it is mathematics integration, so if it's from this time, what is the displacement? You get area 1, you get area 2. Remember, this area is negative. You will get the value subtracted. If subtracted, that is the correct displacement. Okay, but the total distance travel, you just add it. Okay, just add it. It will be total distance travel. Okay, that's all the A max. Okay, with the physics things. Okay, so let's come to the core thing. Oh, before the core thing, let's test you first. Okay. If I have a VT graph, right? Okay, so what is how to explain this object? This object is under what? Under a
decreasing velocity.
Good question. Is it decreasing velocity?
Increasing with decreasing pace.
So is increasing velocity or decreasing velocity?
Increasing.
Increasing. Decreasing. Increasing. Okay, now this is 3, this is still 3.01, it's still increasing. Okay, because the y values keep going up. Okay, so velocity is keep increasing because the y values keep increasing. So what is decreasing then? The gradient is decreasing, right?
Acceleration.
Okay, yep, so acceleration is decreasing. But acceleration positive or not? Okay, so positive, right? So acceleration having decreasing acceleration. Okay? Because acceleration negative, we say it's deceleration, right? So we'll say
acceleration
it's
dropping. Is acceleration less than zero?
No, it's positive. It get closer to zero. Because the gradient is get closer to zero, but the gradient is positive.
Okay.
So acceleration is still positive, but getting smaller. Okay? So how about this?
Decreasing pace.
Don't give me the word pace. Velocity or acceleration? Yep.
Decreasing with decreasing deceleration.
It's a decreasing
velocity.
With
decreasing deceleration.
Decreasing deceleration. So the deceleration get lesser and lesser, is it?
Yeah.
The decelerations, getting lesser and lesser. You're right. Okay. Okay. When you see this graph, right, two things, it always says that the gradients, the value-wise getting steep or more gentle. More gentle means it's value-wise decreasing. Negative means that it is actually a deceleration. Okay, so it's a decreasing deceleration. Okay, so what's this?
Increasing velocity, increasing acceleration.
Good. Okay. Get it? Okay, so all these things, get used to it. Okay. Now a lot of weird things, which is out of our imaginations. Okay. Let's go through a few more. For example, if you have an object, a cliff. Okay. You drop an object, and this object is kind of things like elastic. Okay. So you drop here, and bounce. Bounce. Okay, kind of like that. Okay. So how will it look like? Now what we see is this pattern, right? But when we see this is the pattern in time, remember, we normally, whatever we see is normally the displacement time graph. It will, the velocity time graph, acceleration time graph can be a very different one. Okay, and what is true is that you will take, up to you to take where it's zero. Okay, you take the initial value is zero, can. And you take this floor is zero, also can. Okay, because it's a position, right? So you take initially this is zero, then you have, you take downward positive, or upward positive. Okay, you take downward positive. Let's say, oh, that's totally different. So I start with here, okay, and it is positive, right? So downward positive. At this instant, the vector is in here. Okay, so I will go from here, I'll go to this point, okay? And then later I'll have this point when it bounce back, okay? So when it bounce back the time, I will still have some positive, okay? And then later it will go back the same displacement, so it will be the same height here, okay? And then when time this one, it bounce back, well, this vector is longer than this vector, so it's taller and taller. Okay, so these are the points. Okay, so secondly is how am I gonna curve them? How am I gonna curve them? Okay, curve them just to tell yourself. So what is the thing that governs the curve? Is the gradient, right? How the gradient change? How the curve change? Your gradient straight. Your gradient is constant. Then straight line. Okay, so we talk about gradient. Gradient of this is speed. So tell yourself what happened to speed. The speed start from zero. Okay, start from zero means that the gradient here is zero. Yeah, the y value here is of course zero, but we talk about the gradient zero, right? That means this is a turning point. Okay? So when this is zero, this zero, this zero, this zero, that means these are all turning point. Okay?
No, on top the force will turning point.
Not really. Tell me, when the instant before it hits, fast or slow?
Fast.
When the instant right after it reach, we hit, fast or slow? Fast also, right?
Yeah.
Fast, right? Okay. So they are in high gradient. Okay. So, but before it reach, right, the speed is fast, but direction is positive. Right? So therefore, you have a high, sharp gradient with positive. So most probably it's kind of thing like that. Okay? Right after the impact, right, you have the more or less the same gradient or same speed. Okay, but you have a direction totally on the other ground. So this is why it's like that, sharp. So therefore, actually you have this, with this, with this, with this. Keep going. Okay? So don't be too easy. Tell yourself, what are the specific points first? Plot the point. How will the speed change? Chase accordingly.
Can you plot the VT for this?
Yes, I'm going to do it. Okay? But it's okay, right?
Yeah.
Now, VT for it, you have two ways. Remember, you have two ways. Okay? Must learn both ways. The first way is that if the ST graph is already given, derived from an ST graph, don't care about situation, is the easiest. Because the gradient here is the Y value here. So, at this point, your gradient is zero, so your Y value is zero. Okay? When at this point, if your gradient is high, your Y value is high. Right after this point, the gradient is high but negative. So therefore, it is negatively high. If this is the same, then this is the same. It cannot be the same, because if the same, it should reach the same height. Okay, the speed, the PE, this and that. So this speed you have, right, must be the lesser than this speed you have, actually. So actually, this one should be more gentle than this and that, okay, whatsoever. Okay, so let's, so this value is lesser. Okay, so when it's at here, okay, the speed is zero. So this all point, the speed is zero. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? So at here, okay, and at here, okay, this one is always have a high gradient, and after this always have a low gradient. But this and this is the same, right? Okay, so this negative is the same as this positive. And these two got to be the same. Okay? And then after it bounced, these two are different, so this is lesser. And these two got to be the same. Okay? So later, then you have even lesser. Okay? So you have kind of thing like that. Okay? So after that, you tell yourself, so what is the gradient here? The gradient here is acceleration, right? The gradient here is acceleration. Acceleration is due to gravity, so straight line, straight line, straight line, straight line. This should have the same straight line, okay? Okay? Okay, so this is why you have zit, like that. Okay? For acceleration time graph, if you bother, okay, acceleration is constant. Okay? It's positive because it's downward. But at the instant of impact, right? Okay, the acceleration got to be suddenly very negative.
Why?
So we can't think of that. Very sudden, very sudden. The reason is that if there must be a force upward by the time it bounces, otherwise it wouldn't, at this instant it will not change the speed from down to up. Okay? From down to up, there's a change in speed, right? And this change in speed obviously is upward. So at the time of impact, it must have a high force, but one instant.
There's change in velocity.
Change in velocity, yeah. Change in direction, change in speed also. Right, because I say the speed is lost, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so you must have some force, okay? So you must have the force, and the force must be upward. Okay, you must have a force, and the force must be upward. After this instant, it's already the G, downward. Okay with this?
Mm.
Okay, so there must be some instance of a great force, but it's very short distance. Very short instant, it must be upward against my direction, so that I can change my velocity upward. Okay? Got it? Okay, so that's all about the graph. So let's come to calculate. So it's about the beginning concept, then we come to the graph things, to figure out all these things, and then the last one is the calculations. A calculation come to one dimension, two dimension also. Two dimension is the projectile. Okay, so we calculate, let's talk about one dimension first. Okay, that means only have front and back, up or down, left or right. Okay, there's no two dimension x, y axis. Okay, so in one dimensions, how do we do calculations? Very simple. It's all about accelerations. Okay, if we have accelerations equal to zero, you only have one formula, which is speed, initial or final, doesn't matter. Okay, speed, initial, or okay, final or initial, okay, over speed equal to distance over time. Okay, acceleration is zero, speed is distance over time. You don't use NR equation. Okay, and there's no average speed whatsoever. Okay, so the second thing is that acceleration is a constant or not zero. Okay, acceleration is a constant, not zero. Right? You have four equations. Okay, you have five variables. Okay, five watts. Okay, the five variables are S, U, V, A, T. Okay, S, U, V, A, T. I don't know why to hide it. My camera can catch it. Okay, five variables. We have S, U, V, A, T. Okay, accelerations, time, final speed, initial speed, the displacement between the initial and final position, okay? And this is the time for the initial and final positions. This is the speed of the initial position, this is the final speed of the positions, or velocity of the position, okay? So these are five variables, okay? And each equations, right, has four variables, okay? So what are the four equations, okay? So if you have five variables, each equation has four variables, how many variables is needed to cover all cases? You need four equations. So therefore, they only give you four equations, okay? Because the fifth situation you can derive from simultaneous equation or an R2, okay? So what are the four equations? Anyone you can remember?
It's all in the book.
Yep, can you remember now?
S equals UT plus half AT squared.
Good. Next one?
VUAT.
Sorry? V equal to U plus AT, is it? This one, I will recommend you to remember A equal to V minus U over T. Okay, or V equal to U plus AT, doesn't matter. But why? This one tells you acceleration is change in speed per unit time. So remember the definition of acceleration, you remember this formula. So this one automatically remember, okay? The third one?
V squared, U squared, 2S.
Yup. So actually, right, you need to remember this and this only. This is common sense. And one more is common sense also. And we always declare it. What is that?
S half U V T.
S equal to?
Half U V T.
U V T.
U plus V.
Wow. Remember this way. Cool. Last one. Average velocity, okay, is initial plus final half it. It's also total distance, total time taken. Okay? So this is the fourth equations. Okay? Half it, because acceleration is constant, means it's a straight line. So the average is the midpoint. Midpoint, you add together, divide by 2 with 2. Okay? Total distance, total time taken also can. Now, so what are so special about this four, right? Okay? Is that this one has no V. Okay? This one has no S. Okay? This one has no T. Okay? This one has no A. So when to choose which equation, just tell yourself no what and choose that one. So that means there's one situation that you cannot straight away solve it. You may need to substitute with two simultaneous equations like that, which is in the case of no U. Okay? No U, you need to do two equations, set another variables, simultaneous equation, two equations, one. Okay? So up to you to choose another two equations. Okay? So to solve the no, if there's a no U situation. That means, right, what's no U situations, right, is that no U, okay? So that means you have this four, okay? And one of them is your answer. So let's say this is the answer. Okay, and the rest is given. Given, given, given. Okay, it's the answer. Okay, then how you find if there's no U given? Okay, you choose So you just use any two. Okay, for example, use this and use this. The best is use these two simple ones. Okay, simple. Okay, so you have an unknown U. Okay, and this one you have the A, V and T. A V T. A V T no issue. You have the U, and in this case, right, you have U V, and then S T. Okay, okay. Then substitute away the U. Then you get the answer. Okay, best choose not to have those square things unless you see some zero in front. Okay, so no U you have to, but seldom they give you such a mean question. Okay, normally it's no any one of them, but not you. Okay, now good. So case three. Okay, case three is that when assertion is not a constant, that means it's a function with time. Okay, then you left those account boxes, come up with graph, and then do differentiation integrations. Okay, so this is not in physics. Okay, so we focus on this. So this four. Okay, come on, give me an example. Okay, and we need this here. So example is that when you have an object, right, throw up with initial speed of 2 meters per second, just right at the cliff there, so it drop down later in this way. And the cliff is, let's say, 10 meters tall, okay? So what is the, what's the final speed here? Okay? So tell yourself, okay, S equal to, from this point to this one, S, take upward as positive, if you want. S is equal to minus 10, okay? S U is equal to 2. V equal to answer, okay? A is equal to minus 9.1. T is don't know. Okay, if you need to find V, okay, so you need 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so there's no T, right? No T, you choose these things. Okay, so therefore straight away says V square equal to 2 square plus 2 minus 9.81 and minus 10. Okay, you get the answer. Any problem with this? Okay, but don't do this. Okay. Don't do this. Because in all chapter, in all the physics chapter, before you think about hop into which chapter, right, you must do one thing first, which is the conservation of energy. Okay? Conservation of energy. If case can be solved by conserving energy, you always use conserving energy because it's a lot easier. Okay? The kinetic energy I have is half m 2 square. Okay? So the idea is that and the potential energy initially here is equal to 10 mg 10, okay, mgh, right? This is the PE I have, this is the initial KE I have. So finally when it's here, right, I only left the kinetic energy, which is half mv square. Okay, so no sweat. Okay, this equal to this, because all the kinetic energy, all the potential energy you have here will be all become kinetic energy here. So dot like that. Okay, so m cancel. Okay, then time 2 for everyone. Okay, then V square equal to 2 square plus 2 times 10 times 9.81. So take a square root. Okay, done. Okay, so if COE can do it, do it in COE. So COE if so, when can't you use conserved energy? Okay, conservation energy can tell you the initial final things, but there's one thing that conservation energy can tell you is the time. Okay, time. Either if the time is given, you must use it for calculation, or they ask you for the time. Don't use conservation energy. You cannot give you anything with time. Okay. So then you come back to the equation. So for example, in this case, they don't ask you for final speed. Ask you for time for the whole journey, for the whole journey. Then you don't use conservation energy, because conservation energy can never give you any time. If you find variable will do something with find time, you might as well use this straight away. Okay, so if it is time, okay, you have initial speed U, you have distance, displacement S, If time is needed, you have g, right? 9.1, right? That means you don't have the v. No v, use this equation. Okay, substitute variable inside, get an answer. Got it? Okay, easy. Now, any problem with one-dimension things you want to ask? Otherwise, we go to two-dimension, okay?
Yeah.
Now, two-dimension things is what we call the projectile motions, most of the time, okay? But projectile motion is just one of the two-dimension things you have, okay? The idea of doing two dimensions, right? Okay? Maybe kinematic, dynamic, that means forces, two dimensions, forces in two dimensions, kinematic in two dimensions, projectile motions, anything in two dimensions. Okay? We always do this, okay? We always split it to two times one dimension. Okay? And then do calculations to get one dimension answer. And we combine the one-dimensional answer to the actual two-dimensional answer. Can you see it? Okay, this is how we do. Okay, because we can only deal with one-dimensional things. Okay, so how to handle all questions in your projectile motions? There's actually a very simple way, and I'm going to teach you this simple. All you need to do is to come out a table. 10 questions come, 10 questions do it this way, if you see projectile motions. Okay? 3 column. Horizontal, up to you take where positive. Vertical, up to you take where positive. Then after that, you write that as U, V, A, T. Okay? Once these things come out, okay, these things may take some time for you to fill in everything. Once you fill in these things, right? All the answer you can find in here straight away. The reason is that horizontally, if there is but what to fill first? The thing to fill first is always the A. Okay? You fill the A first horizontally, if there's no force, there's no acceleration. When there's no acceleration, you may not interested on the final speed, because final speed will be the initial speed, so they're the same thing. Okay?
Horizontal will have acceleration if there's initial push in it. Like push off the
cliff. Yeah, so where is the starting of your projectile motion? Is after you leave your hand or while you're still pushing? Then you start a motion.
After,
right? So after you leave your hand is no longer touching the object. Got it? So in terms of force, why at that right instant, there's no force. Projectile motion start with free fall. Okay? And the effect of such horizontal push, right? It always comes in as the initial velocity instant. So we don't care about horizontal.
So it's always zero.
Yeah. So because when you before you leave the hand, right, you cannot say that it is projectile motion yet. So we cannot apply any formula to that yet. Okay? So where's the instance of the projectile motion? Is the right at the instance that the object is leaving something. Maybe aircraft carrier of the bomb or the hand of the push or whatsoever. It's when it left. When it left at the instance, there's no force for it. Okay? And whatever effect that the aircraft or whatsoever have it should all be in the initial velocity. Okay? So, horizontally no force most of the time. But what if later they give you an electron is moving in some way, then gravitational field is downward, but the electric field is left, right, that kind of things. Then you may have horizontal force. Then you may have horizontal field. Then you just feel accordingly. Okay? So just feel this one most of the time is zero, okay? Horizontally. Vertically, right? It is, if you take outward as positive, this is minus 9.1. Or just put it as minus g if you want. Okay? G is 9.1, okay? Minus g is minus 9.1. Number, okay? So, from that onward, right, you know that, okay, I'm going to fill in S, U, A, T. Fill in the values, of course, okay? Then you have, horizontal, okay? Vertical, S vertical, U vertical, and V vertical, and T. Okay? The concept is that, if you want to borrow a variable unknown, right, you can only borrow t. Okay, t is the same. Okay, from an object from here to here at this instant, the time taken for it to horizontally come to here is the same time as the time taken for it to vertically come down to here. Okay, so only the t you can just borrow. We'll call it. Secondly, right, in this column, right, since acceleration is zero, you only have speed equal to distance over time. For that, you got no other formula, okay? But at here, right, you have acceleration which is constant. So the idea is that is choose four. Choose four. Your answer must be in the equation, okay? Otherwise you can't find an answer, okay? So choose four that you're happy with. Got it? Just like that, you can solve it. If you need to borrow, just borrow. Okay, I'm going to give you some example.
What if I borrow?
Borrow means that, for example, I need to find this. The question gave me this, but they didn't give me this. But they give me this, this, this.
So, okay, the
so with 1, 2, 3, 4, I can find T, T, borrow to here, then 1, 2, 3, I find answer. Okay? Okay? For example. Okay? A very abstract example, super abstract example because it got no number. Okay, I'm going to throw an object with initial speed u at the angle of theta. Okay, I should know air resistance, so we'll land it at here. So what is the range? Okay, famous questions, tennis series. I think it's easy, even inside the notes. Okay, what's the range and what is, if I fix the speed, what is the best angle so that I get the greatest range? It's always the questions, okay? Yeah, this question actually is not from physics, it's from further max last time. Okay? So how do we do? Oh,
it's
just like that.
45 degrees, right?
45 degrees, yeah. But how to prove that it's 45 degrees? Okay? To get, it's the same as what your notes say. Except the step procedure, okay? But use my method, it's a lot easier. Horizontal, I take right side is positive. Okay, vertical, I take up as positive, okay, S-U-V-A-T, okay, something else is very important, okay, these two things, okay, if you have any vectors in this way, ever teach this, okay, vector x in this way, okay, you know to split them into components, very simple, the opposite is always sine, okay, the adjacent is cosine. So you see right? This one. Now, on the other hand, if you have two components, I want to combine them back. This is always a squared plus b squared squared root Pythagoras theorem. Okay? And this angle is always inverse tangent of b over a. Okay? So this is give you these two, combine these two, get b. Give you these two, give you split these two. Okay? So remember these two are very handy things. Okay? So, a horizontal distance I travel is r, there are 1, okay? Vertical distance travel is 0 because vertically, if you look at it this way, I didn't travel in anywhere. The vertical vector, the displacement vector is 0. Okay, so 0, okay? This one is u cosine theta. This is u sine theta. Okay, use this. Okay? V, horizontal velocity, I'm not interested because acceleration is 0. Okay, which is the same velocity, if you want to fill in, also can. Vertically, I assume I don't know, actually it's the same thing, but I assume I don't know. Okay, acceleration is g, so g is, the output positive, so it's minus g. Okay, time t is t, time t is t. Okay, so we want to find, when I want to find r, I need the t. The t can borrow from here, so I just choose 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So from there onward, I know there is no V. Okay, no V here. Okay, so no V here. We have S equal to UT. Plus half A T squared. Okay. Luckily we have zero. Bring it over. GT squared over 2 equal to U sine theta t. Okay? Therefore, oh well, t is not equal to 0. I'm not talking about the initial instance. So t cancel. Okay? So then I have, what I want? I want a t, right? So that I can borrow over. So t equal to u, 2u sine theta over g. Okay? So So in here, speed unit is our time, so u cosine theta equal to distance over time. So my distance, r range, right, equal to t u cosine theta. So therefore, it's u cosine theta times this bunch of things, 2u sine theta over g, right? So therefore, you have 2u squared sine theta cosine theta over g. Okay? Okay, 2 sine theta cosine theta, I can have a double echo formula. Hey, sorry, what can be it's R. Okay, so this is u square, 2 sine theta cosine theta become, up to you, sine 2 theta over g. Okay, now g is constant, u square is constant, if the initial speed is fixed. So the maximum range you can have is when this sine theta equal to 1. Okay, so sine 2 theta equal to 1. Hello. How are? Uh-huh. 但是要等一下我六点才完。 好了，我先挂过来。 Okay. Bye. Okay. So sine 2 theta equal to 1. Sine equal to 1 is 90 degree. Okay. So 2 theta equal to 90 degree. So one of the maximum you can have is theta equal to 45. Okay? So 45 degree, the R is max. And what's the max value? It's u squared over g. Okay? So use this method. Okay? Alien things can come up this way. Okay, so let's do something with numbers. Okay? What we have. If I have something shoot at, let's say 30 meter per second initially, and let's say with the angle of 30 degree, and then let's say the height of this cliff is 20 meter, okay, you like that, okay. So what do you want to find? Let's say find the time taken, or find the speed, or find what? Find the speed, okay? Put the speed at here, okay? So what do you have, okay? Horizontal right side positive, vertical up positive. SUVAT, okay? So horizontally, the distance is, I don't know, so SH. Horizontal speed is 30 cosine 30. Okay, final speed, I don't care because acceleration is 0. Okay, so t here, and this acceleration is downward, so it's minus 9.81. Okay, final speed, I don't know, vv, and then the initial speed is 30 sine 30, and the total distance travel is minus 20. Okay. Get it?
How about the initial torque?
Initial what?
The going up.
So, initial going up.
Like you throw thing up and you go down.
Yeah.
How about that?
Oh, you mean at the maximum height here?
To the edge of the cliff, that height. No, from the.
Oh, so
the,
wait.
The maximum height.
What, you mean why is it minus 20, is it? Now, why is it minus 20? Because you draw a vector from initial point to the last point vertically. This is the vector. This vector length is 20. So put 20. This vector is pointing downward against my upward, so it's minus 20. Okay? If you don't draw the SH vector is in this way. Okay? From the initial point to the final point horizontally. It is I, yeah. Okay. So you substitute the correct values. Because we cannot see things in 2D, must be 1D. 1D, like that, that means you go up and then down. I don't care. Initial, final, this is the vector. Right? I'm not traveling about distance, right? It's the vector. displacement. Okay, so if you have this, right, you want to find VV, the vertical velocity, and you just need to choose this for 1, 2, 3, 4. So there's no T, right? No T, use this formula. Okay, you straight away solve your answer. Okay, sometimes you may need to use a GC to press the quadratic answer because you have T square, something like T square, and you may need it.
Then
okay?
What is the...
You want to find time, just choose another 4. Yep.
What is the U here?
The
design.
Yeah, okay, the horizontal speed don't change, right? So it's still 30 sine 30, so 30 cosine 30. The vertical, we use this 1, 2, 3, 4 for to calculate. You calculate the vertical components, right? So after that, you use this to combine back the resultant velocity. This is the answer. Okay?
I'm calculating what here?
I'm calculating the final speed here.
Submit the tangent BOA here.
No, the final speed, right? The final speed or final velocity, right, is actually equal to a horizontal final and vertical final. Okay, and then you resolve it this way. This is the actual final velocity.
Using Pythagoras.
Yeah, use Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so how to get this? It's the same horizontal, so it's 30 cosine 30. Okay, how to get a vertical? Is this value. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, use no T. Okay, use this to go to solve it. Okay, so substitute 3 sine 30 here. Substitute the minus 20 here, substitute minus 9.1 here, okay? Then calculate this to find, take a square root, get a V, okay? Then you have a V value here, then you draw your V value here, okay? After draw a V value here, square both them and square root, add together square root them, you get the final velocity. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Good. Okay. So now, just now I say now if they ask you for the V, okay, you find the horizontal V and vertical V. The vertical V found this way. Choose this for we do right. What if the question asks you to find S, SH horizontal distance travel? Okay. You find this, you need a T. You need a T. You borrow from here. So choose 4. You choose 1, 2, 3, and 4. You don't choose this. So use the one with no V, so to find T, substitute T here, speed, you determine what time, go to find the front distance. Okay?
Yeah, for the horizontal component, you don't take which one? You need to take 4.
No, horizontal component, because acceleration is 0.
Uh-huh.
So you don't have the 4 equations.
Oh, no.
You only have the speed, you determine what time.
Okay.
Speed, distance, and time. Okay, so you need this, you find this.
Over there, right?
Yep.
Use 30 cos 30 and
30 cos sine 30.
Right? To
yep.
Find the final velocity.
Yeah, you're right.
How come you don't use x?
This is not x, this is I'm not interested. That means this actually is the same. Because acceleration is 0, you see. When acceleration is 0, there's no change in speed. No change in velocity, that means the v actually here is actually 30 cosine 30 also. Okay? But I just don't bother to find it, so I put a cross there. Okay, I'm say I'm not interested, but you can just write another. So remember, there's no horizontal V. Okay, don't put any H VH there. Okay. If you want to put the number there, okay, put 30 cosine 30. It won't be wrong. Maybe we just keep reminding yourselves that this sign do not choose four. Do not choose this kind of four equations. Use the speed you decide over time. Okay. Can. Okay. Now there is one question in your notes which is very interesting. It's about bullet shot from a gun that go through two targets. Right. Yeah. The first one. This is horrible. How do you do it?
Yeah, you can continue.
Yeah, okay, so can I take a look at the questions because I need the numbers? Yeah. Now this can be actually done by conserving energy, okay, in an easier way. But let's imagine that in the examination you can't think of how to use conserving energy, okay? So then we just do it in the projectile motion way. We have this. So we have a gun, okay, shoot a bullet, okay, and then you have target, okay, so this is 25, this is 50, and then this have, and then your bullet, right, drop here at 5 mm, so it's 0.005 meter, okay, and then when it comes to the second target at the time, what is this? It's the answer, it is 1. And that's it. Okay, you don't have any more info other than all this. Okay, so how to put these questions? Okay, now if you try to keep thinking, if you can think of it, it's good for you because it will be a lot faster. But assume that you can't think, okay, can't think of it. Okay, in all the projectile motions, I promise that 10 questions can be done this way, unless you can do by COE. Okay, then just do it. The idea is that you have initial instance here, right? So you have how many final instances? 1 and 2, right? So you gotta do 2 projectile motions. One is from here to here. Another one is up to you to choose. You wanna choose from here to here or from here to here? Which one is wiser? Which one is wiser? From here start, to here?
From the start.
From start is wiser, okay? Because this one, the vertical speed initially is 0. You already have some vertical speed which is unknown, which is very hard. So from here to here and from here to here, there are 2 instances. So 2 instances, 4 columns.
If we do it the other way, then we need to add in the initial vertical speed, isn't it?
Initial vertical speed? Yeah, but and you that what initial vertical speed is unknown.
Oh.
Yeah, it's past 1's answer, so it's unknown also. Okay? So it's very dangerous. Okay? So but actually they give you the hint, okay? So we have horizontal right hand side positive, okay, vertical, let's say downward positive, horizontal right hand side positive, vertical downward positive. So this is the long one, this is the short one, okay? Okay, long one and short one. So we have a SUVAT. Okay. Whoa, okay. So from here to here, the whole like 9.1. Okay, this is okay, right? So I'm not interested in this, And this is the T1, time from here to here. This is a T2, so T2, okay? Good, okay, so let's have this. Initial, this one is 25, okay? And this is 50. Vertical distance travel is 0.005, and this is the answer. Okay. So initial speed horizontally is U, I don't know, okay, so U horizontal. But luckily, right, this one is the same U, of course. Okay? The speed I don't know. Initial speed is 0, sorry, 0. Initial speed is 0. And this is good things about choosing this one. Initial vertically, the speed is totally horizontal. well, there's initially no vertical component. Okay, but this two is zero. So the V, right, I don't know, is it VV or 1, VV2. Okay, now all the numbers come out already. So what do you need? You need to find the answer. So how to find it? Interesting, okay? When you want to find the answer, in here, you need four variables. Okay, so, and you need the four variables, including the answer, and some variables can borrow. You can borrow, okay? So you will choose this 1, 2, and 3, 4. Because you know the T can be borrowed. Okay, T borrow from where? From here. Right? So in here, you know speed yield is double time, right? You need to find time, you have distance, you need the speed. So the idea is to come to the speed now here. So where can you get the speed? The speed you actually can borrow from here. Okay? Speed yield is double time. Well, you need a time here. Okay, so you come to the time here. Time borrow from where? Borrow from here. Right? We come here, you just need to choose four. So 1, 2, 3. Okay, so how to do the whole questions? Use this, no V, right? No V, use this. SU, UT plus half AD square, substitute everything. The U is 0, so this term is 0. Okay, S is 0 plus 0, 5, so quite easy to find the T. Okay, find the T already substituted here. Speed is over time, find the speed here. Find the speed here, put the speed here. This speed is over time, find the time here. Find the time here, put the time here. And then you use again, SU, UT plus half AD square, you'll find the answer. Got it? Okay, so what I say is that once the table comes out, right, however complicated your question is, right, play around with it, you'll be able to get it.
The horizontal velocity doesn't change for the whole course.
Doesn't change the whole course, yeah. Because horizontally there's no speed. But the idea of this yield is, right,
is the time to reach the first one half the second one.
You're right. If you have that concept.
What is that? I think the answer is like 0.02.
Sorry?
The answer is 0.02. It's like it dropped 4 times.
It dropped 4 times, yeah.
The distance travel is 2 times more by square.
The time taken, unless you can think of it, the idea is that horizontal speed don't change, right?
Mm-hmm.
Horizontal speed don't change. So, horizontal speed don't change means the speed of the bullet from here to here is the same speed of the bullet from here to here. So you take 25 speed distance over time, you have the same speed, right? This distance tells you the time. So this distance tells you the time also because it's the same speed, right? So the time taken from here to here is the same as time taken from here to here because the horizontal component is never changed. You can observe it, okay? Then you don't need to such a go to your complicated things. But what I want to say is that if we learn this ultimate method, nothing can hide from you. Okay? This is not hard also, right? Pay for, get this.
Why
this yield this?
The zero, I don't understand the zero.
Acceleration is zero,
no,
horizontal?
The initial velocity,
vertical is zero. Vertically, you look in this way, the initial velocity component is purely horizontal, right?
It doesn't move down, baby.
So, no.
Both are referencing from the start point.
Yeah, because both have this same start point. But this is why both U is the same U, and both, this is zero. Because you didn't shoot downward, you shoot horizontal. It dropped down because of the gravity. Okay, so at the first instant when it come out at the time, it's purely horizontal. There's no vertical component. So it cannot be, it got to be zero. Okay for this? Okay, learn this method, okay? Try a few questions with this method, you feel that, wow, kinematic is just like that. Okay? Want to try some of your school questions? Let's see whether my method can suit you.